There's only one thing Jesus wants to give you is victory in every area of your life. Something good.
Welcome to World Harvest Church.
Welcome to World Harvest Church.
Bienvenidos a la iglesia World Harvest.
Welcome to World Harvest Church.
Hallelujah. Good evening, World Harvest Church. Why don't you stand up on your feet with us tonight? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Woo.
Lord, you are.
Jesus' name crashes at the name of Jesus, setting me free.
Into dancing,
turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning, into dancing, turning your mourning,
Come on, press. 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 Hallelujah. 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 Come on, y'all. Come on, stir up the gift that is in you. God has already placed it inside of you. Breakthrough is in your praise. Of God, you are laying on the table and it's time to give birth, and you've got to press, push out the thing that God has already placed in you. What worked in 2021 won't work for you in 2022. The level of praise that you had in 2021 has to go deeper in 2022. The devil has messed with you in 2021, but it is time to give God the praise for your breakthrough in 2022. It's time. You're here. You're here. Whatever it is you want from God, God has already supplied it. It has already been released from the heaven. It's time for you to be like Jacob and fight for what you want. And I'm not going to give up. I'm not going to release until you give me my blessing. Halabasio. Oh, Shamasia Karabasa. Oh, Lababasieke. He's messed with your marriage. He's tried to come in and tear up your home. He's come and tried to wreak havoc in your health. He's come and caused cancellation of your job. But we serve a God who is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that your finite mind can think or what you can ask. Oh, Baba Basie, Kanamaya. Oh, Baba Basie. In 2022, we didn't come to play games. For our Savior is coming again. He's coming again. And he's coming for a church without a spot or a wrinkle or a blemish. It is time to get right with God. Come on, lift your hands in this place. Lift your hands in this place, God. God, you are worthy. You are worthy of all the glory, God. All the honor. All the praise. And we come to worship you, God. For there is no Savior like you. You are the Most High, God.
Belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to you. Oh, my hallelujah belongs to you.
Heavenly language here, Karabasie Karabosa, Rababasie Karabasie, Nanamasu, Ola Mamasie Karamasie Karabosa, Rababasie Karamasie, Ola Namasie, Nanamasie, Oka Mamasie Karamasie, Hasha Mamasie Karabosa. He deserves it. He deserves it. He deserves it.
He deserved 100% of you. He deserved it, he deserved it, he deserved it. He deserved it, he deserved it, he deserved it. He deserved it, he deserved it, he deserved it. Yeah. Ala Maria Shekarabaso. Ola Mama Masia Kalamasia. Ola Mama Mama Masia Kalamasia. Come on, say.
Rotation on in your mind. Say, no, I have many things to be thankful for. My God is a good God. My God loves me. My God is for me. He stands beside me. Hallelujah. I can just feel the faith in this room stirring right now. Are you ready for a powerful night? Are you ready for the Holy Spirit to come and pour out His presence tonight? Hallelujah. So one more time, give one more great shout. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It's going to be a powerful night. Turn to your neighbor and encourage them in the Lord. Say, tonight is your night. And you can have a seat. Hallelujah.
Belongs to the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Well, welcome everybody. It's so good to see you on a Friday night. Hallelujah. My God, what a good God we serve. Wow. If you're here by some chance visiting with us, praise the Lord. Welcome. We're so glad that you're here with us today. It's not an accident. I will promise you that God has a word for you today. Just because you're in the house, I'm going to promise you that God has a word for you today. And it's a good word because He's a good God. Hallelujah. You know something? Tonight is absolutely my favorite night to be in the house of God. It's my favorite night to be in the house of God. Somebody said to me today, I was in the store, somebody said to me, so what are you doing tonight? I said, I'm going to a party tonight. Really? Where's your, my party's in church. They're like, I said, yeah, boy, we're going to a party. It's going to get up on there tonight. I can't wait to get to the house of God. She looked at me like, what kind of church you go to? Y'all know. You know. But when you look around the house of God tonight and you see everybody here, you know for sure that the devil is a liar. Because I can promise you that there's been times this year when you didn't think you were going to make it. But you're here anyway. Hallelujah. You're here anyway. And you say, just for that devil. It's going to be a good night tonight. I'm really excited about what God's going to do. Let me just do some, what do I got here? It's in this pocket right here. You guys know that January is our time of prayer and
fasting.
But our days of prayer out on the table out there, the beautiful desk out there. That was for you, Pastor Linda. Out on the desk out there, there are our January days of prayer and fasting. I want to make sure that you get one. Everybody, before you leave tonight, take one. Before you leave tonight, make sure you get one of these. And let me just tell you this. You know, it never ceases to amaze me how often the church can pray. But we were having breakfast with some family this morning, and they were just telling me about how many churches are shutting down. And I said to myself, wow, we're just getting cranked up. And I believe it happens because we pray. Things happen on purpose when you pray. Make sure that you get one of these before you leave, and make sure that you commit yourself to a time of prayer. And I want to challenge you. See where it says, it's going to say this is as prayer schedule. Then it says specials. See, I'm just teaching you how to read these. It says specials. Where it says specials, what you do is you read and you find your name. Well, January 7th is special. And January 14th, that's special. January 21st is special. The 28th is special. And the 29th is special. I must be special, so I got to be here when a special going on. Amen. So make sure you come out to the house of God. It's going to be absolutely an incredible time. And you know, the other thing, before I even take tonight's offering, because you do realize this is like, instead of Wednesday, we're having Friday service. You know that, right? So we're going to take an offering tonight. Is that okay? Amen. Well, let me just say this. This is just your regular tithes and offerings. But if you do not have an envelope for your first fruits offerings, which will happen at the end of the service, you can raise your hands and the ushers will give you one. If you need a first fruits envelope right now, the ushers are running down the aisles and they will get you one. There's people all over the place. I see leaders with their hands up. What's wrong with you guys? Didn't you write them checks out already in Jesus' name? Come on now. Here you go. Come on. Come on. Run, 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 run. I've always wanted to say that. It's so good. Now, I'm going to come down to here for a second, if you don't mind. Because I can tell you the most important question. This is the fundamental question that determines whether or not there is a God in the house. Amen? And in order for me to get the answer to that question, I had to come down here. Because I've been asked the question at least a half a dozen times today. Please, Pastor, will you tell me if this offering and the first fruits goes on this year's taxes or next year's? Oh, y'all don't know what I'm talking about. So to answer that question, we have the one and only Renee Van Roy. Come here, Renee. Come here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're going to get it right from the horse's mouth.
Oh, I'm a horse now?
Tonight. Come on now. Tell everybody. somebody.
Come on, okay. If you give by check and you put it in the offering, uh-huh. it will count for tonight, for 2021, the contribution. If you give online, it will also be for 2021.
Yes.
But if you put it in the bucket, the credit card, which will be processed next week, it will be for 2022. Okay, you got that?
How about we give cash?
No, that's not allowed. You can give cash tonight and it will count for this year. So if you give online, if you go home after this and you're giving online, it will still count for 2021. Thank you.
Amen. I knew nobody could do it like you. Hallelujah. All right. You know, here's what we'll do. Ushers, if you guys would get those baskets and come on down and stand up front here so people don't have to try to figure out how to get their offerings around the poinsettias. Amen. Do we have more than two baskets? If we have four baskets, then we can spread out a little bit. How about that? Y'all don't mind doing a little administration. Y'all don't mind, do you? Let me just say this real quick on the offering. This morning, in our daily reading, and Kevin, tell me if I'm lying, you tell him, okay? In our daily reading this morning, we were reading about all the offerings that were taken in the Old Testament. And the Lord, it just hit me. It just hit me. Wow, God. I thank God I'm living under a new covenant. I said, God, I wonder if the people know and understand that the offerings that we give are so minuscule. You don't ask us for hardly anything. And it all belongs to you. He could ask us for anything he wanted to, but he didn't. And I said, God, it's an amazing thing that we have an opportunity as people of God to stand in the house of God on the last day of the year when the devil said that you were going to be broke and you were going to lose your job and you were going to lose your house, and we're still here ready to give. That must mean that you're faithful. And then I thought about all the offerings throughout this year. And the tithe that's gone forth, and all the things that World Harvest Church has done to impact the kingdom of God. And I said, devil, you lost another year. And it put a smile on my face and said, you know, God, I had a part of that. I had a piece of that, God. Every soul that was saved around this world, I can tell you I had a piece of that. I want to be that kind of guy that I can look the devil in the face and say, I had a piece of that soul. I don't care where it was. I had a piece of that. That's the kind of God we serve. And tonight, when you give your offering or your tithe tonight, I want you to really get a look in the spirit that there are souls impacted by your giving. There are souls being impacted by your offerings tonight. Amen. And if nothing else, he deserves it. Let's pray. Father, we thank you so much for the opportunity we have tonight to be givers. God, what a privilege it is to be able to give tonight into the house of God for the work of the kingdom. We do it for your glory, God, and for you alone. In Jesus' name, amen. And amen. Come on and give your offerings. You can just drop it in one of those four buckets. We got four up here. You can make your way up front. Hallelujah. Or you can give online, of course. You guys know how we do it. Father, thank you so much for the divine multiplication of the supernatural seed in the house of God. Father, we believe that tonight is a supernatural night. Lord, you get to start it all over again in us, oh God. And we thank you that tonight's offering and tonight's tithe, oh God, Lord, will be multiplied supernaturally in the name of Jesus for your people. And all God's people said, amen and amen. 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 Pastor Merrick.
Let's give Pastor Willie a hand. Appreciate my dear brother, Pastor Willie. No, you can not right now. I believe this is the most important time of the year, and I can't think in my memory of a more critical time in our history. If you know anything about what's going on between the prophetic word of the Lord at the end of the Bible and the times we're living, we are living in the last hours. These are the final days. And so we have to get very serious about our faith walk. We can no longer play the church game. I'm just telling you. I'm finding always one other Christian who is a minister that just, we're going to pray for them, but right now they lost it. And they go to other ministers that qualify or encourage where they are, cursing in their texting. I'm saying Jesus. But you know what? For the body of Christ, if we line up with God, this is the greatest days to be alive. I mean, this is the day that other people have looked for to be a part of. If you think yourself, you got to pinch yourself that of all the generations that have been on this planet, God picked you to be right here today on planet Earth. Is that amazing? Is that amazing? Last year's theme, or this year's theme, was moving forward. Because if you remember it, the whole thing was COVID still fresh and alive, and now we got whatever wave it is. And we have a doctor in the house. Somebody's here today, but Dr. Josh Uptegrove. I'd like to know someone. It's not theory. It's not reading. He's in the trenches. He's in the ER at Northside. That's all he deals with. So he's dealing with reality, not TV, whatever, propaganda. And he was just saying, you know, this last wave, just to let you understand, because he texted me, he just said, you know what? This is a lot lighter than anything we experienced before. It's a very light thing. He said, relax. It's going to blow through. Just keep on going. I said, thank you, Dr. Josh Uptegrove. Amen. And amen. And so, closing down, seriously. But moving forward was our theme. And so in everything we did in this church, we moved forward. In every capacity we could think of. We met as a staff. It was, what can we move forward in? One of the greatest things to move forward is in launching one-to-one every Saturday. If someone can praise the Lord, that's moving forward. Moving forward, nearly two dozen trips all over the world. When we told people, what? What? No, because we're moving forward. And we move forward in two encounters, moving forward with two forever frees, moving forward with all the things. We just kept moving forward. We put the tent up, hallelujah, we're moving forward, hallelujah. And in 1 week, we got all the equipment to completely heat that tent. So get ready, get ready. We're going to unwind that thing. Get ready. We're moving forward. We've completed, hallelujah, the video booth. Come on now. Put your hands together. And we just kept giving and going and serving and blessing. We never stopped. So that was this last year. We moved forward in every way. We moved forward. We had the biggest offering we ever had for our first fruits. We just moved forward. So the question is, what is today's theme? And I want to just say this to you. I don't do this lightly. It doesn't come out of a Cracker Jack box. No, really, I go to the Lord about it. But this was in my spirit. It just said, you know, God, we've moved forward in 2021. But it just kept boiling in me that God's got something unusual for this coming year. It'll be different. It'll be more powerful. It's going to impact nations. Because God will never be outdone by what the devil does. Never. Never. And it will impact you individually, and it'll impact us corporately. Well, get on with it. Get on with it. What is it? What is it? The prophetic word for World Harvest Church in 2022. Mark it down. This will be the year. Of the supernatural. Glory. Yes. Yes. Glory. Woo. Yes, it shall. Yes, it shall. Yes, it shall. In Jesus' mighty name. For your light has come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. Hallelujah! Glory! Woo! Be seated if you can. I tell you, hallelujah. And I don't check what other people are doing. I don't check web pages. I don't check. Don't check nothing. We just check what God says to me. And so I have a video we put together that kind of encapsulates some of the things we're talking about and what you can look forward to for 2022. But let me say this. There's individual faith. There's corporate faith. If you plug in to this body of believers and you plug in to what we're being teaching, what we're teaching concerning the word, your faith will rise up. We're going to be connected. There's more power when we flow together, united in our faith. But go ahead and roll the video. With all that's going on in our world today, the challenges in our country, increased COVID mandates, continuing rising inflation, growth of crime, and even the propagation of anti-God principles in our schools, universities, and in the public arena in general. In this hour of darkness, God's light is bursting through. Revival light is coming to our churches, and a great spiritual awakening is spreading across this nation. We serve a supernatural God. Our birth is supernatural. Being filled with the Holy Spirit is supernatural. Being born again is supernatural. The gifts of the Holy Spirit, they're supernatural, and they've been given to us. We are created for the supernatural. 2022, God's grace shall abound. There shall be signs and wonders and miracles, gifts of healings, working of miracles, and the gift of faith. God's power shall be released through our hunger for God and His Word, through our passion for souls, and in our unshakable faith in the living God who loves us and is for us. This year will be like no other. Supernatural, above and beyond the natural. We are releasing our faith in the Spirit and believe the power of God to be poured out upon our finances, upon our health, upon our families, upon our ministries. You've called me to a life of the supernatural.
of signs and wonders.
2022 is the year of the supernatural.
I mean, like, the Holy Ghost is excited. For those of you who don't know it, I keep referring to this because I love him. My brother Ted Shuttlesworth gave us the prophetic word, and I looked him up because I followed Dave Wilkerson for years. He came to our university way back in the 70s. And he had a word for our nation. He operates in a true prophetic office. It's in 1984. He said, the Lord showed me, because he was pastoring a very large church in Times Square in New York. I see a plague striking the city. I see it shutting it down. I see people dying. I see the plague spread across our nation and across the world. Isn't that something? You see that in 1984? But a period of time passed, which I want to just say, COVID is passing. COVID's not here to stay. It's passing. But he said, when it passes, there'll be the greatest spiritual awakening this nation has ever experienced. It's going to not only touch this nation, but it will spread from shore to shore, border to border, and cover the globe. And so I'd picked this out before I heard the prophetic word. But I believe with all my heart that God is looking to do exceedingly abundantly above all that you can ask or think in these last days. I promise you, it's going to happen. So I've got some scriptures. In fact, I had to hold myself back because I got going. But I want to bring the word to you. And I want to talk about this because I believe you got to build your faith so you can receive that which God has prepared for you. Out of the book of Mark, we go to Mark 16. And we're going to talk about signs, wonders, miracles. Would you say that with me? Signs, wonders, miracles. It's amazing you study scripture. Those are always in plural, not just one sign. Signs, plural. Wonders, plural. Miracles, plural. But look what it says here. Jesus said this about us, the church. Starting with verse 17. He said, and these signs, everybody say signs. These signs will follow those who believe. Do you believe? Yes. In my name they will cast out demons. In my name they will speak with new tongues. They will take up serpents. And if they drink anything deadly, it will by no means hurt them. We need that just to go to some of the restaurants we eat. And they'll lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. Now watch this. So then after the Lord had spoken to them, he's received up into heaven and sat down in the right hand of God, and they went out and preached everywhere, the Lord working with them and confirming the word through the accompanying signs. And the last scripture said, amen. Now I want to go jump to Acts 2, verse 22. Men of Israel, hear these words. Jesus of Nazareth, a man attested by God to you by miracles, wonders, and signs which God did through him in your midst. Father, make alive the word to our hearts. May it not just titillate our senses and minds, but let it drop into our spirit that we capture what you are doing in these last days and that we can move forward and march as a mighty army to bring your kingdom to this earth in Jesus' mighty name. I said amen. Amen. It says in 1 Timothy 4:1, it said in the last days, there'll be a departure from the faith. It's that people that are in the faith will give heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils. That second book of Timothy, same chapter 4, verse 3. It says that for the time will come when they will no longer endure sound doctrine. I love what the Passion puts it. They will seek out teachers with soothing words that will line up with their desires. Man, I'm watching that all the time. Line up with their desires, saying just what they want to hear. And all the while, they close their ears to the truth, choosing to believe fables and myths. Ladies and gentlemen, this hour is upon us. It is absolutely upon us. And I know this, that God is not just God, He's supernatural. I have a dear friend who'd always greet me. I thought it was a little bit strange, but I understand what he's trying to say. His name is Rufus. Why not? Why not? When you'd say, Rufus, how you doing? He would say, super naturally. I said, okay, Rufus, keep the Romanian humor into Romania. He's from Romania. But the Bible talks about that we serve this God of the supernatural. And I got to studying this, the more I got into it. Signs, wonders, and miracles. A sign is a confirmation of a biblical truth or reality. A sign. A wonder is what grabs you and takes an unbelieving, skeptical mind and goes, wait a minute. What I just saw is shifting what I believe. And a miracle, the word is dunamis, is the mighty outworking of God's power. It's the word even supernatural ties into the word miracle. It takes what could never happen in the natural scheme of things or the natural power of man. It supersedes what man can do. And so when you say it's going to be year of the supernatural, it's going to go beyond your natural capacity, your natural thinking, and your natural ability. But God wants us in a place of complete dependence upon His power because He wants to do the supernatural. But we have to be positioned and we have to be ready. And so I'm going to preach and teach along this line so everyone can tap into it in the name of Jesus. And not one will lose out. But supernatural. Acts 7, it says this in verse 36. He brought them out, talking about the children of Israel. He brought them out, and after he had shown them wonders and signs in the land of Egypt, in the Red Sea, and the wilderness. Signs, wonders, and miracles. I started looking up. It's all over the Bible. God likes signs, wonders, and miracles. What's the first miracle in the Bible? Well, you might argue the point, but one of them, I believe, is in Genesis 5, where a man named Enoch, the son of Methuselah, he lived 380-some years. The Bible said he had a son around about 70. But he said for 300 years, he sought the face of God. No Bible, no church, just he wanted his spirit, said there's a God out there. And when he sought him to the place where God saw him, his faith pleased him, and it said God took him. He took him, body, soul, spirit, everything, right out of the planet. Now that's cool. And then we see another one in Genesis 15. God just starts a little slow, but he picks it up. In Genesis 15, we say, you know, Abraham was told by God that he's going to have this nation and all this stuff, and he's got this wife and himself that are in the natural. It can never happen. So he said, Lord, show me a sign. Everybody say sign.
Sign.
Okay. God says, I want you to do get five different animals. One, get a three-year-old heifer. Two, get a three-year-old goat, and then a three-year-old ram, and a turtle dove, and a pigeon. I want you to cut them in half. I want you to lay them down in a line. And I want you to sit there and watch till I show you something. The Bible said that during the day, the vultures came to try and eat the flesh, and Abraham shooed them away. But it wasn't until night he fell into a deep sleep and God showed him a vision of his people go to Egypt and come into bondage for 400 years. When he came out of that, all of a sudden, the Bible said God showed up as a burning oven and a flaming torch, a smoking, burning oven. I mean, there was a fire came out of nowhere. And the fire began to walk through the pieces of broken flesh. And that was a sign to Abraham that God will fulfill his promise. And he did. When Isaac was born, let me say this. If you haven't figured this out biologically, a 100-year-old man and a 90-year-old woman cannot produce children. That's why Isaac is nothing but supernatural. I love my friends in Nigeria. I've been twice at this time of year down to Pastor Adiyepo's church. Massive, massive crowd. And one after another, these women would come up and said, I have been called barren by the doctors. But I came on here 2 years ago, 3 years ago, and you prayed over me. You know what's amazing? You got to be careful how you pray. Only one would have one. Many had twins. One had triplets. What's that called? Instant family. Praise the Lord. Think about this, Pastor Chris. You could have triplets. But Isaac was a miracle. Jacob was a miracle. What does that mean? It means that it's something outside the natural. Esau was a miracle. You go through the whole line, and then you see Moses. Moses had a sign. Exodus 3. There's a bush that's on fire, and it's not burning. He goes over there. What's going on? Why is it not burning? And then God speaks to him out of the bush. How many know that's supernatural? And then I love where Moses, in Exodus 4, he said, now, Lord, you're sending me to Egypt, to Pharaoh, the most powerful man on the planet, and you're telling me to go up to him and say, let my people go. What's the sign that this is really happening? You know what God told him? See that big staff you got in your hand? Yeah. Throw it on the ground. Immediately he threw it on the ground, it turned into a snake. He jumped back. He created his own enemy. You know what God told him? Don't be chicken. Reach down and grab that snake by the tail. And as soon as you do, it'll turn back into a rod. And he did it. Became a rod. Put your hand into your bosom. Put it inside his robe. Pull it out. It was filled with leprosy. You know what he said after that? Egad. No, he didn't say that. He said, put the hand back in. Put it back in. You pulled it out. It was made clear. And I tell you, when you look at this thing about God, you start studying. Just study the supernatural aspect of God. From cover to cover, he's a supernatural God. For 10 plagues, it was supernatural. He brought the Israelites out. It was supernatural to take a Red Sea and move it apart. That's why a whole image is the Red Sea parting. It took a miracle. It took the supernatural for God to time it just right till the Egyptian army is following them. And then for some strange reason, all their wheels fell off. And then, by coincidence, the sea came back over them, and they were destroyed. Let me tell you this. You may have some enemies today, but God can take care of the enemies by the supernatural power of God. I promise you this. Some of you, we're going to talk about this, are in your own finances, in your own marriage, in you with your children. Everybody here needs some supernatural move of God. But you're going to receive it in Jesus' name in 2022. Get ready, get ready, get ready in the mighty name of Jesus. The supernatural is so much. I'll just touch a few. They came to the very first lake that had some water in it after they crossed the Red Sea, and it was salty, it was bitter. And so Moses says, take a tree. It was called Marah. He said, take a tree, throw it into the lake, and the water becomes sweet. They did it, became sweet. You know what that's called? Supernatural. What's bitter in your life? God can make it sweet. Just like that. I promise you he can. He can make it sweet. And then you go all the way down the line. How do you get a rock to give out water that's just a big stone in the middle of the desert? But God said, touch it and it'll bring water. It brought water. How do you have a bakery in heaven bake enough bread for 2 million people, and it shows up on the ground every single day except the Sabbath? How do you get quail to come in at like about 3 feet off the ground just waiting to be hit? Listen, I've hunted quail before. Quail go from you to someplace else, and they go at a very high rate of speed. And I think God put them in coveys so they wait. If you know anything about quail, as you're walking down, you're walking along the field, and they don't just sit there, cheep, cheep, I'm going to fly. They wait till you're about 3 feet away, and then they take off like an explosion because that's part of their defense mechanism. While you're going, what the? They're gone. And so you look at the quail, and you look at everything that God did. You march on down the scripture. I love Samson's parents said, listen, we need a sign. How do you know this is happening? That you're going to have a son that's going to be the judge of Israel. And so the man of God said, well, bring something to me as an offering. Put it on the rock. He said, here's the sign. Touched the rock, big flame, consumed it, and the angel stepped into the flame and disappeared. Now, the men in the Bible, sometimes not the brightest. The man, Manoah was his name, told his wife, we're going to die. We just saw God. His wife said, you fool. How can we see the prophetic word come to pass unless we're alive? We still haven't even produced a child yet. Manoah was brought back to his senses, and he was good for a little while longer. You go through the whole thing. One of my favorite is Balaam's ass, donkey. I mean, he tells this donkey, you know, he's beating this donkey. He's going to kill it. He's beating and beating it. And finally, God gives the donkey a voice. And all of a sudden, he says, what are you hitting me for? And he's looking around. This jackass has an opinion. I tell you, God, I think also God has a sense of humor. I honestly believe he does. And you can go right on through. I can go march on through the prophets. They're all, you know, Elijah. I love Elijah. Elijah's so cool. You know, he says, it won't rain. It doesn't rain. 3.5 years later, it can rain. It'll rain. It's called supernatural. I can remember, I watched that in my early, when I first got saved the second time. I was truly saved. And we would meet for prayer in the university campus, University of Kansas State University. They had a little chapel there. Every 4:30, every morning, we would meet there for prayer. And we were going to pass out like 15,000 Good News Bibles, our group was, to all the campus students. It was a big operation, and it had to be a clear day. We had all the things, and it had rained for like 2 weeks nonstop every day. The prediction was 2 more weeks of solid rain. We told God, God, it will not work unless the sun comes out. We were in the chapel. It was raining cats and dogs. We're praying. We said, God, we need to have an open heaven. Because it's tomorrow. I'll never forget it. I'm just a young teenager. We step out. It stopped raining, still overcast. And while we're standing, look at the sky. I'll never forget it. The sky opened up and a blue patch appeared. Did you know what? It was a sunny day the next day. And did you know what? As God's my judge, it rained for 2 weeks after that nonstop. So for me, as a young Christian, I said, we stopped the rain for one day to get the gospel out. Amen. It's a sign and a wonder. And I don't know about you, we need signs and wonders in these last days. God wants to do it to his people. And if you go all the way through, I won't go through all of them. I'll use that for other times. But Elijah's my favorite one. It's supernatural to have an Uber from heaven. In the form of a fiery chariot. Can you imagine? I think about Elijah. Was he forewarned? I mean, how do you do this? Here comes a fiery chariot. The horses are fiery. The chariot's fiery. It comes on down, and you just get on it. And then it takes off. And as it takes off, you said, oh, yeah, my mantle. Elijah, this is for you. You'll need it. And just, and that's supernatural. You know, Elisha, how did Elijah die? You don't want to know. Don't talk to me because you think I'm taking something. But no. But you go down through the line. Everything. You look at the word, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. How can you walk in a fiery furnace? Daniel, how can you walk with lions? You go down through the Bible, and then you cannot stop with when you get to the New Testament. It goes to another level. Jesus, in John 2, it said the first of the signs, use this word, the first sign. That's why signs are important. Signs tell people that there's a God of the supernatural. Signs. I believe we're going to have these things happen where we had Elimaeus, the great, the man who was telling Paul that, you know, running him into the ground and stopping him from sharing to the proconsul, the leader of the territory. And Paul says, you man full of wickedness and all guile, I command you cannot see that there'll be a, he said, you will not see until God's word gets done. And it said a mist came upon him and he was instantly blind. Now some people, get ready, supernatural things. They'll be interviewing somebody. They'll be going, well, let me tell you what I think. And all of a sudden, I can't see. Who turned the lights off? Sir, let me lead you to a quiet room where I can share with you what's happening. It's going to happen. The supernatural is going to happen. I fully believe it. But Jesus, the very first thing he did, he turned water into wine. And then the Bible said a little bit further. He said the second sign, it gives him like God's counting the signs. The second sign, a nobleman from Capernaum came up to Cana, where he just made water into wine, and said, my son is sick and dying. He said, don't worry about it. Go home. He's well. Well, you haven't come to pray for him. I said, go home. He's well. And the man went home, asked the servants, when did he get well? They compared the hours. The same moment that Jesus said, go home, he's well, was the time that he got healed. How many know that's supernatural? You see, Jesus is into supernatural. God's into supernatural. He likes going above where the natural is. I think he likes to just mess with people's heads. Like I say, you know what? You think that's good? You think you're so smart? Because men, through their own pride and selfishness, they got it all figured out. God said, no, you really don't. And these signs, one of the miracles, are here to arrest you and turn your faith to God. That's what they're for. So if you take a look at what Jesus did, he pulled Peter, go fishing, and the tax money is in the fish. The question is, was the money in the fish all along? Or as he pulled the fish up, did God create the coin? Does it really matter? Does it really matter? Now, Peter was smart. After he took the coin out, he kept the fish and ate it. But that's another thing. To feed 5,000 and then 4,000 with just a minuscule little lunch. To take blind people, open up their eyes, deaf. And, one of my favorite, the madman of Gadara. He goes up to this man, and the devil tries to stop the boat from crossing by a storm. He makes it through anyway. The end of the story is he casts the thousands of demons out of this man and left him completely sane. And I wonder what Jesus, you know, this man, so he's only saved 1 hour. And Jesus says, go into the cities and tell them what God has done for you. Sometimes we train people too much. Just get to getting. If God's touched you, go tell people. Well, no, I have to get my degree. No, you get the degree later. Just go tell them. Go in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. And so everywhere you go, I don't care where you go. Then we go, well, that was Jesus. Well, they moved to the apostles. You can't, everything you look at is the gate beautiful. A man's been there crippled for 40 years plus. And Peter and John said, silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, give I thee. In the name of Jesus Christ, get up and walk. And he gets up and walks. Well, it creates such a pandemonium that when he shares Christ, 5,000 people came. Wow. So what does the devil do? He locks them up. He can try to lock us up, some of us, but that's okay. God's into jailbreaks. He lets Peter and all the apostles out. You read it. Acts 5. He let them all out. He broke them open. He said, go and share the words of this life. And then we get Peter. He's locked up again. And then we hear about all these soldiers, 16 soldiers are all around him. And God works it out, so he just walks right on through. Let me say this to you. God is going to do the supernatural in 2022. Hey, that rhymes. Where's my rapper? Help me. I got the first two lines. Help me further down the line. But let me just say this about miracles. We have to contend for the miracle. Everybody say contend. You got to contend this thing about miracles. You've got to want them. You can't say, well, if it hits me, most likely it won't hit you. But if you say, you know what, this is the year of supernatural. God's doing the supernatural in these last days, and I want to get into that flow. Everybody says, I love God's supernatural. I want the supernatural. You got to get that on the inside of you. And I want to talk about the major reason we want the supernatural. The first, I know why I need the supernatural, because I need a new job. Well, before we get to you, can we get to something a little higher? Like, what is the purpose of the church? Signs, wonders, and miracles are the tools God gave the body of Christ to bring the great harvest of souls into the kingdom. That's what it's for. It's for the harvest of souls. And I can't tell you, there is something about when you go on the streets, we do one-to-one, but something about praying for people and watch them get healed. I mean, my brother Marcus, you'll never be the same. He's in a crusade, and we're praying for all the sick people are getting healed like you pop popcorn in a microwave. And I'm not making it up. But he was given, one of the women came along and gave him a dead baby. A dead baby. It's cold. I know some of you would say, you need to give this to the mortician. But he said he held that baby, him and another sister, and prayed for 20-some minutes. Said, God, bring life back to this baby. And all of a sudden, the baby got warm. And all of a sudden, the baby's eye began to flicker. And before long, that baby was alive. And come on now, it's a true story. I'm not making it up. We got many witnesses. Many witnesses. And all of a sudden, that baby is walking. We never walked. You see, that's a miracle. The supernatural flow to my brother. You know what it is? There is something in these last days where everyone's talking, many talking heads. But what'll turn people around quicker than anything else is a miracle that they have no idea how that happened. The supernatural is what God's going to release. And I believe it's going to be us reaching up to him, but it's also going to be him pouring down to us. Because there are seasons that God brings. Seasons. I'll never forget it. If you study the great healing revival, it's about 11 years. About a year after World War II, for 11 years, I mean, they had massive tents all over this nation. Oral Roberts had the biggest one. And they had literally tens of thousands jammed under these tents. And they were being healed by the thousands. It paid national television. People were being healed. And then after about 11 years, they just dried up. People sold their tents. But you know what the great tent company that we got our tent from? He said, we have never produced so many tents in our life, in our history. We've been around since close to 70, 80 years. And he says, we are 6 months to 9 months behind in orders. And every preacher I get, we just bought a tent. We just bought a tent. We just bought a tent. I mean, so we're not the only ones getting a tent. Because I believe that wave of the supernatural is coming, and it's coming upon the body of Christ if we will catch the wave. The wave of the supernatural. God's going to use you to raise the dead. He's going to use you. People come out of wheelchairs. He's going to use you to preach. I mean, watch this. To preach under the power of the Holy Ghost. There's going to be something supernatural coming. Are you excited in the name of Jesus? And the Bible says about Jesus in John 2:23, he says, many believed in his name when they saw the miracles that he did. It's going to slap the devil sideways. The supernatural move of God. Hallelujah. But we must have the supernatural. Brother Ted talks about this. He said, you know, one time I was in the early days, I was in Illinois, Southern Illinois. And as we went to church, we passed this field, and it was harvest time, and the Amish farmers were harvesting it. And the men had one of that big sickle. They were cutting it. And the women came by and were tying it into sheaves. And they were working this huge field. There was a field on one side and a field on the other. He said, when I came back at the end of the service, I looked over and they may have got a third of the field done, the Amish. But all of a sudden, I looked over to the other side of the road. It was completely harvested. And the end of the field was a combine harvester. And the Lord spoke to Brother Ted, which just speaks to me. He said, son, trying to bring in the harvest without the supernatural is trying to gather wheat like the Amish. But he said, when you employ the supernatural, you become a combine harvester that can bring in the souls by the millions. Now, I don't know about you, but this is before I heard got the word from the supernatural. But I promise you, the supernatural is released in the body of Christ through the gifts of the Holy Spirit. And you see, we've got to understand that God says, this is what is the tools to get the job done. And it's not just for me up here, it's for you and every believer. That we operate, listen to me, in these supernatural gifts. There they are, the harvest tools that God wants to use. And anything is, if you've done anything about ministry, I've found far greater signs, wonders, and miracles out there bringing the harvest than I've ever done in church. There's something about when you get out there on the front line and you're trying to do it for God and say, God, right about now, I need a miracle. Right about now, I need the supernatural. Go up with the supernatural. And the supernatural, when it hits people, when they come the next night or whatever else you're going, they bring their teacher. You can say whatever you are. But if your mama is dying of cancer and God touches her and the doctors confirm she's completely cancer-free, you're bringing your aunt, your cousin, your demon-possessed nephew. You're going to start bringing them all over. Fix this one. Fix this one. And but they'll know. He said, how do you do it? Through the name of Jesus Christ, who is the living Christ, who shows himself alive and well by the signs, wonders, and miracles that he's did to you right today. I want you to get excited about what this year is going to bring. And the world's giving out the doom and the gloom. We're going to bring it out shouting the praise and the hallelujahs in the mighty name of Jesus. But I believe this. God is pouring out a spirit. Now this spirit, I believe through the gift of faith, we're going to have divine protection. Believe me, I've got to be careful how I put this. We had more things happen to our vehicles trying to go to do the work of God than any other time. They're like, there's the white bus for WHC. Aim for it and hit it. Or even my blessed drivers, they would forget where they were and run into things. But the problem is, we are going to have divine protection going 2022. You are going to walk around every vehicle, plead the blood of Jesus, speak the name of Jesus, assign angels, but no one is hitting us anymore in Jesus' name. It's called the gift of faith and divine protection. But you need divine protection for everything. For COVID. You need divine protection for all the sickness and diseases out there. You need to understand God has those tools for us, but we've got to want them. You have to say, I got to have the supernatural. You got to have it. Listen, I tell you what, I'm so hungry for it, and I'm willing to give something for God to work with. That's the key. Give something for God to work with. Well, what do you mean? Well, the Bible says that you can build up your most holy faith praying in the Holy Spirit. God gave you something more supernatural than manna, water out of the rock, that God said, I will pray through you for you if you release me. It's called the baptism of the Holy Spirit. And one of the first fruits in the Bible, Jesus said, he said, in my name you will speak with a heavenly language. You will speak with new tongues. I mean, a tongue you never learned. It's so supernatural. And I want to just stay in that a minute. Some of you may be hearing, well, what's he talking about? Well, let me say that. I was like you one day, but I got some training. And I found out that this is just so real. It's the greatest tool that God has given us. And the devil doesn't want you to use it. That's why I challenge you to come to prayer. Well, I'm tired. I'll be fasting. Well, take a Red Bull. Whatever. Drink coffee. But come. You got to get, just make up your mind. In fact, my next sermon on Sunday, you can't wait, but I'm going to talk about you got to give up in order to go up. You've got to give up to go up. Listen, there's no free ride in the Spirit. And sometimes we can do well in business, we do well in everything else, but when it comes to spiritual things, we can cave. Because the mind says, what are you doing? You're not doing anything. Yes, you're building up your spirit. Yes, you're releasing the power of God. Yes, the gifts shall be released in this house in Jesus' name. We've seen nothing yet. I will not be satisfied until guests coming in this church, as they're driving down the driveway, we have to have parking lot attendants get ready to jump out of the way because they'll be overcome by the Holy Ghost and pull over and have to stop. He said, what happened to you? Something came on me when I came in here. And just hand them tissues because they're weeping under the conviction of the Holy Ghost. And all of a sudden here, a demon just left. Another shake and twitch, another one just left. I mean, and we have to carry them in here. They said, what happened? And now they're going to come in here, get delivered, get healed, get so saturated with the glory of God, they'll walk out of here staggering like this. Where have you been? I've been to Joel's bar, and I got so filled with the supernatural power of God. God promised, and the last days he poured his spirit upon all flesh, and it's going to bring about the supernatural. The supernatural. But you got to be hungry for it, and you got to give God something to work with. I want the supernatural, Lord. As you're clicking through the channels. No, that's not how it works. You got to give God something to work with. But we got to also recognize that we got to get this expectation for the supernatural. Everybody say expectation. You got to get, I don't care, in your finances. Now listen, there's some of you here that are challenged financially. What you're doing right tonight, when you bring a seed of significance to Jesus Christ and you release it, God has a way to supernaturally promote you, supernaturally put you in a place you would never get to on your own, cause funds to come to you. How did this happen? He can give you supernatural ideas. He can give you supernatural supply. And in Jesus' name, just believe big. I've heard some people, I'm believing for a house. People go, oh, look at that. That's crazy. They're believing for a house. I had to pay for mine. Well, be quiet. Your faith was one mortgage at a time, little note at a time. Their faith, let me reach out. Someone can just come along. I promise you, God can show up in someone's bedroom. A man who can cut the check. Cut that person a check for whatever. I mean, it's going to happen. Supernatural things in Jesus' name. I believe it's going to be supernatural in how we move forward in this property. I've been meeting different people that have means. They're not even part of this church. You know what I can do is say, God, you know the people I know. You know who needs to be talked to. And as we sow, we're going to believe, God, you're going to speak to people in Jesus' name. It can happen to you. It can happen to me. But I want you to know something. Supernatural promotion on your job. But you've got to, now listen to me, you've got to provide, you've got to give up to go up. Maybe give up your coffee breaks. Maybe give up some of the evenings where you just want to watch the wretched where you could be studying. Really, we have to think this through. Everybody say, I got to give up to go up. You got to get that. You got to get that in the spirit. Stephen said, I would love to have your job. Oh, really? Let me tell you where we have the armor. And let me show you all the dents, the dings, the bangs, and everything else on it. It's like everything comes with a price. Nothing's free. But I'm telling you this, the supernatural is what God wants to do in 2022. I promise you. But we have to, listen, give God something to work with. Give God something to work with. Don't sit there like a bump on a log saying, well, sister, I'm going to sit here. Where's the supernatural? Well, move towards him. Move towards him. How do I start? Start with desire. You got to want it. Yeah, I want to see my business. And if anyone's in business, you understand this. In these last days, help fund the gospel. Make the money to get blessed, but fund the gospel. Get the missionaries out. Get the work out. Fund the gospel in Jesus' name. If that's your passion, God will make a way for you in the name of Jesus. It can't be just about me, myself, and I. And I want a new set of pots. God's got more stuff than that. He loves the pots. Ain't nothing to him. But you got to keep your heart right in the name of Jesus. And so you got to understand this. Supernatural signs and wonders. But I want you to see me. You got to step over. We got to step over into the spirit. You cannot do this walking in the flesh. The Bible says they walk in the flesh. They mind things of the flesh. But they that walk in the spirit put their mind in the spirit. And the mind of the spirit brings in a place of peace and rest. But there's a place of the supernatural in the spirit. Everybody say in the spirit. You remember that they would say that the prophets, Elisha said this one time, play minstrel. As he played, the spirit of God would come upon him. There's something about God. You need to make this first month of January. And I'm tying it down. I'm done. I think. They got no clock. This is great. They did that for me. Praise the Lord. But I have a watch. Wow. I always think time advances supernaturally up here. If anybody's been up here, you know what I'm talking about. But step over. You gotta step over. You gotta step over. Listen, God, I'm gonna step over. 2022, and it begins. You gotta make some commitments. Say, God, I want to get with you. You know, if you don't do every prayer meeting, but do the prayer meetings you can do. Make a decision. You're gonna get with God every day. That this 21 days of prayer and fasting, which we'll share, which I want to share just in a brief minute. Get engaged. Give up some. Starbucks, give up some pie, give up some food, and then what? Put prayer in its place. I didn't say starve to your skeleton. I said, but give something up. Everybody said, you got to give up to go up. Now, that's the way it is. You want more of God? You got to press into God. Now, as for me, I want to just press in. I want to press in like I've never pressed in this year, and I like to press in. In fact, I'm putting this all together, and a revival just popped in my mind and heart. I said, wow. I feel like God, I said, wow. But you know what? We're not going to back down, back off, but you got to step over. It says, when you set your affections on things above, you set your affections on things of the Spirit. God, you know what? I know that you're counting on the body of Christ to want what you want to give so desperately. That Jesus, you paid the atoning sacrifice that we can receive that which is supernatural on our behalf in Jesus' name. How many of you just want to go to sick people, lay hands, and watch them instantly get well? Come on now. Come on now. It's time. Okay, how many of you in your finances, you won't be able to sow and speak over your money? And listen, some of you business people, you're thinking too small. I met a businessman today. He's talking about, well, I got this, I got to pay this, and this, and this. I said, it sounds like chunk change to me. He said, what do you mean? I said, think of the potential you could make. I think about it. I said, what if you triple or quadruple what you're doing? He said, well, there'd be no problem. I said, that's how you're going to think. You think of this, well, this is what I make, and this is what I do. I mean, what are you talking about? I mean, I bought some gifts online. I've never, this is all new for me, this thing called Etsy. It's a whole new world. But I got some stuff, like, I looked at this place, like, it was called, I think Midville, Maine. I looked it up. It's in the middle of absolutely nowhere. What do they got? They got bog, dirt, and granite. You know what this guy's doing? He's chiseling the granite. He puts it on a turnstile. He's making all kind of vases. It's a vase of Oz. I'm originally from England. I always get everything. It's vase. No, it's vase. Whatever. And so I'm looking at this guy's boom business. He came, and so I got one. I said, this is so cool. Out of a dumb rock, he's created something that's going to fund his business in the middle of nowhere. Etsy. I said, this is amazing. You're going to make money. You're going to make money. You're going to make money. I told Pastor Bob, I spoke to him. I said, listen, some of our people need to make money. He said, it's so easy. I said, well, would you show our people? He said, listen, give me 6 to 9 people. I'll sit with them for 2 or 3 days, but pick the best ones. He said, I make like nothing. I made, with hardly trying last month, I made over $7,000. I said, where's the line for them? Listen to me. It's going to be, everybody say supernatural. Supernatural. Don't you love the word? Yes. Say it real loud, supernatural. Supernatural! That's what God has for you in 2022. It's going to be upon your, listen, supernatural healing is going to flow. Supernatural finances are going to grow and increase. You're going to see it. And your family, in Jesus' name, you know those people? I've been with some. Oh, I love them all. But some of them are as lost as the goose in a storm. Just out there. I said, what are you? I'm an agnostic. My God, what, you're 31? How can you be an agnostic? I better quit saying that, right? But the point is this. Your families are coming in Jesus' name. Those people, we said, oh, they're getting saved. Not one is being lost. Is that what we said? They're coming in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Listen, families are coming in. And listen, some of you are in ministry. You're in ministry. And you're in this position. Humma, 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 humma. What's the next step? You know what I'm talking about? Got this call. And you did that all last year. The year before that. And so now we're coming to 2022. Listen, you got to quit the spiritual calisthenics. Listen, you got to get a hold of God and say, God, you're going to supernaturally guide me by your spirit. I'm getting a rhema from God. A rhema from God. And listen, and there'll be a supernatural supply. But you've got to want the supernatural. You've got to crave the supernatural. You've got to give God something to work with. And so I fully believe it's going to happen. Paymasters will be raised up into this house. Supernatural. People that learn how to spell million. We don't say, can you spell million? But can you spell billion? It begins with a B. But anyway, you got to learn these things. We have to get the mindset. Does that make sense? It makes sense. But I feel like it's a rhema from heaven that this house, corporately and individually, you're going to experience the supernatural. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I feel the power of God here. I feel like some of your kids that are out there, smart but stupid, they're going to come in. God's going to visit them. God's going to visit them. You know what I want God to go after? It's my personal pet peeve. Go after university professors that think they're that smart and just show up with angels, Jesus. Just show up. Just show up. Super. Just show up. He's going to do it. You mark it down. And I promise you this, high schools, grade schools, elementary schools, universities, God's going to use the young people to bring revival, fire, spiritual awakening. It's going to be supernatural. I feel like there's going to be a wave of financial increase, a wave of people coming to Christ. I'm not just saying these things. I just know in my heart, it's like, does the Spirit witness with you? It's like, it's time for the supernatural to be birthed in the body of Christ. And Lord, it'll be birthed right here. Everybody shout out, this is my year for the supernatural move of God. In my life, in my finances, in my family, in my physical body, in my ministry. A divine release by the power of the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, man, I feel faith in the house. I feel faith in the house. Oh, tala mama rusikiti. Oh, la mama ria sikio lokoya. Ajela mama rusikia. Hashala. But I just hear the Lord say, for the anointing shall arise upon my people in a greater and greater measure. And I shall call the fire of my spirit to be upon your life. And the fire shall cause you to be strong and powerful in these last days. And what the enemy would bring against you to bring you down, you will cut through with the fire of my spirit. That will melt before you, your enemies, like butter before a hot knife. You will see my hand go before you. And I shall do the supernatural. I'll even do the unexpected, says the Lord. I'll put you in places that you will never know how you got there, but you'll turn around and know I put you there by my hand and by my favor. And I will cause great favor to come upon my people. And you shall see angels going ahead of you. And some of you will see them with your own eyes, says the Lord. But you will see the supernatural. You'll move in the supernatural. And a new dimension shall be released even in these last days, says the Lord. For those who want to step across that which I've called them to do, step across into that spiritual world of the supernatural. Hallelujah. Everybody say, I'm stepping over. Right, that's another sermon title. I'm stepping over. Lord, I just lift up everyone here today. We each have different challenges. We're all different places with you. But God, there's one thing we have in common. We recognize Jesus Christ is the Son of God and that He is the King of glory and He's coming soon. Lord Jesus, you told us to occupy till you come. You told us to clothe ourselves with the armor of light. You told us that the glory of God shall arise upon your people. And that you'd pour out your spirit upon all flesh in the last days. And Father, you know these are the last of the last. And so, Lord, we surrender our hearts to you. We lay everything on the altar of Almighty God. And we tell you, Father, our life's not our own. It belongs to you. Yes. As you speak to us, we will obey. Yes. And Lord, we press in for the mighty, powerful gifts of the Holy Spirit. The gift of faith. The working of miracles. The gifts of healings. Tongues interpretation. Prophecy. Discerning of spirits. Word of knowledge, word of wisdom. Lord, these gifts we must have to bring this harvest in. Thank you, Lord, for this great year that lies before us. We give it over to you. And we claim even now the supernatural. In Jesus' mighty name. Whew. Feel the supernatural power. Sana mohota karari ala kanaya. Ajala mamaradaya. Otala mamarodu sidika babawaya. Ojala mamaradi ala mamarodoya. The 21 days book. Sobariyata kiyata koro soya. I'm going to give you the book this as you leave, the book I've written a devotional for 21 days. If you take one and just read it every day and pray, have a confession, we can all stay together on the same page. Man, I feel the power of God here. Holy Ghost, thank you. He's going to do it. He's going to do it. I just know, listen to me. We've seen a lot of such supernatural things in this house. We've seen it both here and abroad. It's going to pale. This book, 21 days. It says prayer and fasting. On Sunday, I'll talk a little bit more about fasting, but fasting means you stop eating. And how much you stop eating is on you. One meal a day, 2 days without meals, then the third day you eat. Whatever you have, I got it all here. I got a whole booklet that tells you what to do. I wrote it out. How you fast. And you fast according to what you feel comfortable with, where your faith level is. Amen? I want my wife to come up here real quick. And I'm doing something a little bit different. Yeah. And we're going to have Pastor Willie and Sister Flossie on one side. Oh, you're going to stay down there? Yeah. Everybody said the devil's a liar. And my wife was, this crazy stuff's going around. And so she was like, Pastor, I better not be praying for people today. She's good though, aren't you? That's cool. I said, you're good though.
Oh, yes.
She wants some help. So I'll pray. We'll pray together. And then Pastor Willie and Sister Flossie are going to pray. So we're going to break up together. Amen. So you're going to put this envelope in our hands, either one of us. We're going to touch and agree. This is huge. You release your faith. Peggy, this is your time. Where'd you go? I love your testimony. You can release your faith. I release my faith for the miracle power of God to be released, the supernatural, in 2022. Supernatural. But I want to pray right now for those that are out there that you are doing it from your home. There are a lot of people out there. And I want you to zoom in. Come here, honey. See, I color coordinated this so it would kind of not clash when you get close to the camera. Put your hand on that, honey. Okay. You're zoomed in? All right. Take your gift. Not you guys. These guys. If you'll take your gift, put it in your hand. If you have a wife next to you, put it in your hand. Put your hand on it. And we're going to pray a blessing over you. Father, in the name of Jesus, we touch and agree for those watching online that the first fruits offering is offered to you, Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. And we release our faith for divine multiplication. Let supernatural blessing be released in Jesus' name. Favor of heaven to be released. Divine increase upon their household. Lord, we claim what they're reaching up to heaven to receive. We claim it for them that comes in 2022. The supernatural power of God is released in Jesus' name into their lives, into their families. And we call it done in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. Let's give the Lord a shout. Hallelujah. Okay, so we have the praise team coming up. And they're going to be singing a song. Oh, they're playing. Oh, I misunderstood that. I thought, isn't that nice? They're going to be singing live. That's okay. I misunderstood. And you get the books on the way out. Don't get them now. And let me just say this to you. There's no obligation to do anything. You say, I just came for the service, don't want a gift. That's fine. It's whose will, let them come. Does that make sense? And I'll try to be quicker this time. I will do a better job in the name of Jesus. Antoine, come here a minute. Yeah, I got to follow God. Come here a minute. Bye. Show them your shirt.
Oh.
I'm addicted to God's word. Give him a hand.
Expect something in 2022, sir. In the name of Jesus.
Yeah, I let me just say this. I just feel a drawing. I keep looking, getting a drawing by the Holy Ghost. You know what? It's going to be a supernatural recovery in Jesus' name. It'll be supernatural.
Thank you, Jesus.
Now, what the devil meant for bad, truly God's going to make for good.
Amen.
You're a married man.
Yeah, yeah.
You're a saved man.
Yeah.
You're a Holy Ghost filled man.
Hallelujah. Yes, yes.
And Jesus needs you in this kingdom.
Ooh, and I sure need him. Amen.
Everybody put your hands out here and just say, thank you, Jesus, for the supernatural power of God going through my brother, that he shall be healed.
Yes.
Made whole in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Now, I feel that going into you. Let me say this. You come up and offer prayer. I just felt led to do that. You don't mind, do you?
No, not at all. I love it.
Give him a hand. All right, here's how we're going to do it. We're going to make it quick. I'm going to do short words if I have a word. If you laugh, it'll lift off me. But we're going to just come from the front row. The men are organizing it. Please get up. And why don't you get over there? And then... we touch and agree in Jesus' name for divine increase.
Amen.
We release our faith.
Supernatural right there, God. Yeah. The prayer, God.
Wait a minute, I got it for my own self. In the name of Jesus. Divine supernatural increase. We release our faith. In Jesus' name. All right, so you say, well, how come they're the front row? Well, if you're front row, you get privileges, but further back you get. But let's just play the music and stay in the spirit of worship. Amen. Yeah, if you're not coming, you're free to go.
Are you ready for a miracle?
Lord, this is, we release our faith for their future,
are you ready for
the call,
for, a
for the ministry in Jesus.
Yeah, are you ready? Ready? Ready?
Lord, I just see breakthrough in this seed being released. Everything you need. And I call the money in. I call everything in. I call it a supernatural building. Angels go, bring it to them. In Jesus' name. This year going to be off and running. This is your year. I love you. Love you so much. Love you, love you, love you, baby.
Jesus went unto the well and made the water wine.
In the mighty name of Jesus, I release my faith for her family. Everyone comes into Christ. Everyone comes into Christ. And the divine release of her business. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I love you.
God bless you.
Are you ready for a miracle? Come on, are you ready? Ready? Ready?
We release this seed for family members.